When all the cells of multicellular body has exactly same DNA, then why they are different in structures and functions? How a single zygote cell can differentiate into different cell lines with same set of genetic material? Answers to these critical questions lies in gene regulation. So what is gene regulation? Gene regulation is the controlled expression of genes based on the presence or absence of certain determinants inherited from parental cell during initial cell divisions or environmental effects or environmental factors. Now let's talk about the different examinations or test a gene has to pass before going into a complete functional protein. First level is transcription level. Second level is RNA processing level. Third level is translation. And the fourth level is post-translational modifications. Transcription level may involve transcription factors, nucleosome composition, DNA methylation, and insulators. RNA processing may involve alternative splicing, RNA editing. Translation involves microRNAs and small interfering RNAs as silencers and translation regulatory proteins, RNA stability. Post-translation modifications involve feedback inhibition and covalent modification. Let's discuss all these factors one by one in a brief time. Transcription level regulation. Transcriptional factors are proteins that control rate of transcription. They can turn on or off genes. There are 2600 transcription factors in human genome. Nucleosome composition. Arrangement and order of nucleosomes in chromatin can initiate or avoid transcription. If the arrangement of nucleosomes is wider, they can allow attachment of proteins. But if arrangement of nucleosomes is narrower, they would not allow the attachment of proteins and the process will halt. DNA methylation. Methylation of DNA usually silences the transcription. It prevents the attachment of transcription factors to DNA helix. Insulators. Insulators are the agents which can limit or confine gene regulation to a specific region of gene and limit transcription process, not allowing the whole gene to transcribe. Now, what is difference between transcriptional factors and transcriptional elements? Transcriptional factors are all agents which are involved externally in regulation of genes, like activators, repressors, or transcriptional factors overall, while transcriptional elements are part of regulatory sequences of genes like promoters, enhancers, silencers, etc. RNA processing. Alternative splicing is a selection of alternative exons change the message in messenger RNA occurs due to activation of proteins involved in splicing. Similarly, base sequences in messenger RNA are edited, resulting in messenger RNA variants, which change the target proteins to be formed. Pre-messenger RNA or immature RNA contain both exons and introns. But after splicing, mature messenger RNA is formed, which have only exons, and the arrangement of exons can be altered here, resulting into different variants of messenger RNA, and hence the target protein will be changed. Translation level regulation. MicroRNAs and small interfering RNA can silence the translation, a process called RNA interference. Similarly, proteins that bind to 5' end of messenger RNA regulate translation, they bind or not will decide the future of messenger RNA. RNA stability. RNA binding proteins decide whether messenger RNA will stay stable or will be broken down. Post-translational modifications. Feedback inhibition is the control by amounts of products formed. Products back regulate the folding and activation of proteins. Addition or removal of chemical groups to single or multiple amino acids in the protein can alter the functioning. So to reach to a functional protein, all these checkpoints must be passed. In this way, a single or same type of DNA after regulation can produce different cell types and with different structures and functions.